Advantage Lithium ist einer der zahlreichen Rohstoff-Juniors, die im sogenannten Lithium-Dreieck Argentiniens auf der Suche nach dem bei Investoren und Anlegern derzeit wohl gefragtesten Rohstoff sind. Wir sprechen heute mit CEO David Sidhu, um uns genauer informieren zu lassen. David, welcome.
Welcome, thank you for having me on today.
You're welcome. We're going to talk about Advantage in a bit, but with resource juniors, it's always a good thing to know about the management. So please introduce yourself to our audience and give us a bit of background about
Sure, it's
yourself.
great to be on the show today and introduce myself. I've had extensive experience in the resource markets. I got into the brokerage business in the early 1980s. I worked at Canaccord and Yorkton Securities for many years. I worked my way up from a young broker to a partner at Yorkton. I worked with the Natural Resource Group, Frank Giustra, Bob Koss, and Trevor Wilson quite closely. And we developed a lot of mines. We worked with Robert Friedland in Voisey's Bay. We worked with a number of people in Alta Petroleum. The guys who founded Alta Petroleum, I put a deal together called Gasco Energy, which was bought out by Pioneer. I worked with my good friend Paul Reynolds at Canaccord at that time. We jointly worked on it, Canaccord and Yorkton. And I did several resource projects. My latest one in 2011, 2012 was called American Oil and Gas. We sold that to Hess for $630 million
Oh,
in all
nice.
transaction, and I was a founding shareholder of that company as well. And I'm a real believer in team, putting people around me that are a little bit smarter than I am, understand the resource sector and all the drilling nuances. So I've had about 30 years experience in the resource industry, built two companies, sold them to majors, and this is my third one now with Advantage Lithium.
Well, you could say third time lucky if your other companies hadn't been a success already. Well, let's get to Advantage Lithium. You're one of several companies looking for lithium brines in Argentina on a project called Cauchery, if I pronounce that correctly. Tell us, what sets you apart from the competition?
I think what we wanted to do to really develop another solid company, as you said, we wanted to make sure we had the right assets and the right partner to work on these assets. Lithium is not an easy product to produce. The last on November 7th and 8th, we had a site visit there, and I think a lot of institutional players and analysts that were up there, there was over 52 of them, saw that it's not easy to produce lithium. So what sets us apart a little bit, Bjorn, is we have a strong partnership with Orocobre. They've been there for 10 years. They've got a facility, the only one built in Argentina right now, processing facility in Cauchery, in that basin. They've got a large resource of about 6 million tons. They've done great work with the community there. We've got excellent assets. We sit in the middle of a salar in Cauchery. On each side of us is Orocobre that has 6 million tons, and on the other side of us is LAC and SQM that have 12 million tons, and we're right in the middle of that. So I think that really sets us apart from some of the other juniors. We've got proven resource already there, and we're building that out over the next 6 months.
As you said, you're working together with Orocobre is just your neighbor, but they are not only a neighbor, they're also a stakeholder. So give us a bit more of information what this partnership could mean for your company and your project in the future.
Sure, I think it's important for the listeners and readers to understand that the partnership is a real collaborative effort between Orocobre and Advantage Lithium. They have two members on our board, two senior people, Richard Saville and Rick Anton, joined our board. I have four board members that are my board members, and Orocobre put two people on, so we do control the board from that standpoint. Advantage does. We also raised $20 million at the end of March, and all that money, Bjorn, is going into the ground to drill up and increase this resource in Cauchery. So Orocobre did not take any money for the deal that we did. And most importantly, we inherited the entire exploration team from Orocobre that was part of the management team and exploration team that built Olaroz and discovered the brine that they have in Cauchery. So that's very significant. Starting in May, we had 33 employees immediately, very technically sound. And that's really important too, to have the right people that understand how to bring a project like this size to the marketplace and bring brine into the market. So that's a strong collaborative partnership we have with them. And lastly, and more importantly, is the community relationships that Orocobre has developed with the community, the women that work there, the villages, the First Nations people, indigenous people there, they work quite closely with. And we've got a great relationship with them as well. And that's partly to do with the hard work that Orocobre's put in. They've won several awards for social consciousness and environmental consciousness as well. And we've inherited all that, and we're basically picking the ball up and taking it just exactly like Orocobre did with the local communities.
Well, it's always good to know what you can do has already been done, or what you're aiming to do has already been done. But tell us a bit more about what you have done. You said you've already got a resource proven, and I saw some very nice drill results out lately. Tell us a bit more what you already achieved.
Sure. By year end, we'll have finished 5 rotary holes and 4 diamond holes. And so far, what we've done is in the southeastern part where Lithium Americas has most of their resource, we believe that the results that we're putting out in the marketplace, that we're going to increase that inferred resource of 477,000 tons by the first quarter of 2018. So the southeast drilling that we've done, we're going to increase that resource. And then we drilled up in the northwest where no one else has drilled. It's the asset that we have there is about 15,000 hectares. And we've drilled 3 holes now there. One that we press released on November the 7th when we had the site visit in Jujuy with all the analysts and bankers. And that result came out very positive. We had over 600 milligrams per liter in an area that nobody else has drilled before. And we had a 60-70 meter sand package, which is very good for flow rates for lithium. So we're excited that we believe we've opened up a new zone in the northwest, Bjorn. That's very significant for us.
Okay.
So this whole Cauchari Basin is still developing. You know, even though Orocobre has 6 million tons, that they have there, and Lithium Americas and SQM have 12, we think we're still developing a bigger resource in our area, and those companies will continue to build a resource in Cauchari. Cauchari is a very vast open space. You know, when you look on the map, it looks like it's a little bit tight, but it's quite vast there. It's very open.
Okay, very interesting. So probably more drilling to follow, and then what are the next steps then?
Yeah, we're gonna next week we're gonna announce hole number 16 in the northwest. We have all of the zones from 100 meters to 300 meters. We'll have results for all those holes, all those zones rather, next week, and then we will also announce appointment of a senior project development person to take us now to the next level. We'll finish our drill program for the end of this year, so we'll have those 2 results coming out in November. So we'll have some hole number 8, 9, 10, and 11. We should have those announced by December, and that'll complete our drilling for 2017. And we'll have spent the $5 million that we need to spend in Cauchari to earn 75% of Cauchari. So we will own 75%, and our partner Orocobre will own 25%. Then in January, we'll continue deepening some of those holes in the northwest and in the southeast to build more of a bigger resource. And by the first quarter, Bjorn, of 2018, probably by March, April, we'll have a new NI 43-101 report with a new resource number defined.
Very interesting. A lot of stuff to look forward to for investors, for you too, of course. It sounds like ambitious plans, though, and all that doesn't come cheap. So you said you raised 20 million initially, or in the latest round. Do you have all of that still left, or will you have to go to the markets in the near future?
No, that's a good point. We have 12 million US still in the bank. To get to finish our new scoping study and new resource in early 2018, we're going to only need another $500,000 max to get that done. So right now we are not foreseeing going to the market to raise any capital at this point. We've been approached with the market activity that we've had. We've averaged, I think, over 80 million shares in the last month and a half in volume. Our market cap has grown. We're starting to get closer to some of the other exploration juniors in terms of market cap. And we don't need to go to the market for capital. We've been approached by a lot of people, but at this point, we don't want to do the extra dilution at this point.
Okay, very good to hear from a point of view of an investor. Now, as you said, your market cap has grown. Your stock has gone up quite a bit already in the last couple of weeks and months. So it has had a very good run. So why should people start looking, in your personal opinion, now to take a position in advantage?
Very simple. If you look at Lithium Americas, they've got 6 million tons that they've proven up in an inferred, indicated, and measured category, Bjorn, and their market cap is close to $1 billion, okay? Mm-hmm. Our partner, Orocobre, has 6 million tons proven up, and their market cap is around 1.3 to 1.4 billion. If you look at our market cap right now compared to where they're at, and you look at the results that we're having, they compare as good or better than the drill results that our partner Orocobre had and Lithium Americas had a few years ago when they were building out their resource. So if you put two and two together, if we're having the same results that they're having, if and some grades higher, and we've opened up a new zone in the Northwest, that 500,000 tons that I'm talking about that we have in the Southeast is going to grow significantly. And even if we're half of what those resources are, if we prove up 2 to 3 million tons, this stock is a $500 million market cap company, and we're sitting at $160 million market cap. Very simple math. We're in the right basin, the right place, same results, if not better than our partners and our neighbors. And I believe by the first quarter of 2018, we're going to have a significantly higher resource than 500,000 tons. And I think the upside is huge for us right now. And we have the technical team, we have the financing, we've got a seasoned partner, and we've got the funding that we need in the future if we ever do. And we understand the basin. And as Lithium America said in their presentation in New York, that the brine and Cauchari seems homogeneous, meaning that the chemistry of it seems to be almost identical. There's not much difference. You look at some of the other exploration companies putting out results, their magnesium to lithium ratios, Bjorn, are like over 10, 11, 11 to 1. And that means there's a lot of impurities in their brine. Ours is 2 to 2.1, which is identical to what LAC, SQM, and Orocobre's had. So it's very fine brine. You don't have to spend a lot of money processing it. Other exploration companies that have higher magnesium to lithium ratios, their cost of production is going to be much higher than us. So just look at the simple numbers. And if you came on the site visit and I took all the bankers, I showed them where we're drilling in the Northwest and the Southeast, and 500 meters away from us was Lithium America's drill rig.
Okay. So they came
together and said, wow, this is quite close to where they're, where the other companies are having these big results are. So pretty simple math.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you for taking the time, and we'll be sure to hear more from you in the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Take care.